How much do you identify yourself as a writer? How much do you think about that in terms of identity? How much of your writer's block comes because you're focused on yourself as a writer? I want you to know that you are not a writer. You're a human who writes. You're a man who writes or a woman who writes. You are a child of God. You are an image bearer of the Creator, and therefore you create. And if writing is what you create, so be it. What you're doing is you're living out this image bearing of the God who created you. And I want you to think of it as just a job. So here's what you're here to do. You're here to live. Primarily, you're here to glorify God, but you're here to glorify God by living your life. What that means is you're going about doing what God put you here to do, which is to live. And a major part of living is eating, is paying the bills, is sheltering and feeding your family. And if you were put here on this earth all by yourself, you would have to work every day to feed yourself and to keep yourself safe. And when you're writing, that's the same thing that you're doing, especially if you're writing for a living. And I'm guessing if you're not writing for a living, you'd like to be. And so if this is your vocational calling, then it's your way of hunting. It's your way of building shelter. It's your way of doing that as a creator. God gave you gifts and desires and purpose so that you can go out and use those gifts and desires and purpose to create. And in creating, you can feed yourself, you can live. It's about more than making money so that you can eat, but don't underestimate how important that aspect of it is. Think of this as a job, not something by which to identify yourself, but a job. I was saying this over on my other channel at christianman.me that I used to be an opera singer, another kind of creator, and I would create music and I would go create a performance and I'd play a role in a show to make money. And at the time I didn't know Christ and I didn't have any other way to justify my existence except that people wanted me to come and sing. They liked what I did. Therefore, I was extremely vulnerable to criticism because if you attack my performance, you attack me. And if you attack me, I just might as well shrivel up because do I even deserve to live? And that's just no way to be. And I got into writing quite by accident. I was writing as a hobby on a gig platform called Fiverr.com. I still have a profile as a pro seller on Fiverr, but I started out as level zero with no experience. And by the grace of God, I get a job, I get another job, get another job, get another job, get good ratings, get a good reputation, get rated up by Fiverr, rated up, more ratings, more reputation, raise my prices. Next thing you know, like I'm a writer for a living. And then I make my website, christianghostwriting.com, and I find myself, I'm a writer. I do a lot of ghostwriting, co-writing, writing for myself. And it's a huge joy to wake up every day and create words on a page that feeds my family and supports my life. And the fact that I get to do it doing something that I love, I understand. I'm blessed. Since day one to today, I see it still as just a job. It does not define me. If you don't like what I write, it doesn't define me. If you don't like this video, it doesn't define me. If you don't like me, it doesn't define me. What defines me is what God says. I'm a man, which means I'm a creation, a creature, created by God in the image of God. A son of God. He sent his son Jesus to die on the cross to save me so that I could be his child, so that I could be with him creating an eternity as an image bearer. See, God put each and every one of us on the earth and delegated authority to us and gave us resources. He gave us assets. He gave us gifts. He gave us desires. He gave us callings. He gave us purpose. He gave us the ability to acquire skills and grow them exponentially. That's what a steward does. So that we could live, so that we could glorify God with our life. Life is the purpose of your life. And that creative purpose, the writing, or the entrepreneurship, or the sculpting, or the drawing, and painting, whatever kind of work you do, He gave that to us so that we could live our lives. Don't ever judge your personhood by your work, because your work can always improve. It can always get better. You will always find someone that likes what you do, and you will always find plenty of people that hate what you do. All you need is just one person to come along and pay for it so that you can feed your family. That's all it is. If I'd have known that when I was an opera singer, I would have been a much better performer and much happier doing it. And I wouldn't have judged myself by what others thought, because you're always going to find someone that doesn't like it. I'm not saying don't put your heart and soul into the work, but just don't make it what it isn't. Don't make it what it isn't. Don't make it an idol. Don't make it a sign that you deserve to live. It's not. Do have a growth mindset about it. Do know that you can do better. You can always do better. You can always grow in your abilities. You can always grow in your skills. I've got a heart to see humans create, especially believers, especially people that understand what it means to be a creator in the image of God, the Creator, capital C. I want to see you put out there into the world, especially you writers. I want to see you put your words, your truth out there into the world. Like, what do you mean your truth? Isn't truth objective? Absolutely. But my truth is my objective truth, meaning the objective truth that I hold dear, that I want to be saying, like what I'm doing right now. Sometimes my truth turns out not to be true, and I find that out by sharing it. And I think we all grow if every one of us who's been given messages from God to share with the world will go out and do that. You want to talk to me about how I can help you do that? Feel free to reach out to me at christianghostwriting.com. You can contact me there. There's a Calendly link in the description of this video. You can contact me that way. I would love to hear from you and hear how you think about these things and what God's doing in your life as a creator. Other than that, have an awesome day and get out there and make something.